I'm looking for an opponent for tomorrow night. I don't suppose a big scrappy youth like yourself would want to wrestle the real world champion, would you?
I'll give it a try, yeah.
I saw you come out here last night and stick up for me and all those little holsters, brother. And I know what you've got to do tonight. I know that you got to climb in the ring and face Mr. Flair. You see these boots, brother Dave?
Wow, and yeah. My God.
You put these magic slippers on, you get in that ring with Ric Flair, and you're going to beat him like yesterday's news, brother, and save just a little piece of Ric Flair for me so that I can end his reign in the WCW, his reign of terror, brother.
Look out!
Oh, my gosh!
Look out!
Hogan!
What is he doing there?
Hogan picks up! Hogan picks up where Dave Sullivan left off! He couldn't stand by and see it!
Now you tell me that's fair! Two against one! Who does Hulk Hogan think he is? He's choking him! He's choking him!
A week from this Sunday, Flair, anybody is your partner. I'll get in the ring with you if you put your career on the line also in Halloween Havoc.
God wants to see it. Fans all over the world want to see it. Who is he? Oh, my. There's another one.
No.
There's another one.
Brother, he got him right in the leg. That's his bad leg. I talked about a mistake. A coward. Brother, I was afraid of this right here. There's so many guys out there, masked men coming from all over. Ric Flair, I said he might deal his hand tonight. It looked like he has. Hulk Hogan is definitely in a lot of pain.
And now, Kevin Sullivan coming out, putting the boots to his brother.
Man, come on, where's the referee?
Referee, we need the National Guard out here.
Look at Sherry. Sherry won't let him go either. Got a hold of him right there. And now this masked man.
Oh, look what he's doing to Hogan in the ring. Flair, the masked man, Sherry.
Here we go. Let's get some help out here.
Hey, when you need a friend, you turn on friends. They're as close as brothers, and that's what you've got right now.
And I think, Eric Bischoff, that's all Hulk Hogan's got left is the fans and the friends that are like brothers.
Gentlemen, on the eve of Halloween Havoc, please welcome to Saturday Night, along with Sensuous Sherry, 11-time champion, Bobby Trimoy, Ric Flair. It all comes down to tomorrow night in Detroit on pay-per-view. Sensuous Sherry won't be able to help you. Nobody's going to be able to help you. It's just going to be you and Hulk Hogan inside a cage. One man walks away a champion. The other man walks away from this sport forever.
You know, on the eve of the greatest sporting event of all time, it occurs to me, Gene Okerlund, that I don't need to explain to you or anybody out there just exactly what it means to be Ric Flair or what it means to be Hulk Hogan. Because only two men in the history of this sport know what it means to be one or the other. That's Hogan, and that's me. Forget about the masked men. God love the queen, and I do too. But forget about the queen. Because tomorrow night, Hogan, you can read it in the USA. You can hear about it on TNT. They'll talk about it around the world. It's Hogan versus Flair. It's career versus career.
Oh my God. whoa, what about Mr. T? You can't duck that subject any longer.
I don't have to duck it. You worry about Mr. T. I know what Mr. T is all about, and I know where he'll be tomorrow night. What I want Hogan to think about is through all this, since the day, don't give me any time cues, pal, since the day he walked into WCW, there was never room for either of us. Never room for Hogan and Flair. Only room for one. Tomorrow night, Hogan, I'm saying I'm the better man. I'm saying I'm the better athlete. I'm saying I'm a lot smarter. I wouldn't put my career on the line if I didn't know what I was doing. Why would the greatest of all time walk away at the height of his career? He wouldn't go to bed tonight. Look at your beautiful wife, those two beautiful kids, and remember that tomorrow night is forever. Not just another night, it's forever. You were 5 times World Wrestling Federation champion. That means nothing. Tomorrow night, you've got Flair. Head up. Career versus career in the steel cage. And look into my eyes, big man. Look into my eyes. They say I'm the dirtiest player in the game. They say Ric Flair can come back better than any athlete alive. Tomorrow night, I'm going to show you and the entire wrestling world why I've deserved to be number one since it all began. Tomorrow night, big boy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I wish I could say a rather succinct message from the Nature Boy. He and Hogan on pay-per-view at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. It is the biggest match in the history of this great sport. Still to come, Hulk Hogan here on Saturday night.
And there's the Magic Slippers falling out of the Hulkamaniacs.
Well, put your heels together and look back to Kansas, punk.
Look at this closing down.
Oh, yeah, he thinks he's Hulk Hogan.
He wants to be just like his idol. Here it is.
Well, he's not going to be heaving Kevin Sullivan through the air. I guarantee that. And he's not going to be throwing him around like he's throwing Rip Rogers around.
He might.
Use all the Hulk Hogan moves you want. Drop the big lace. Kick him in the face. Do whatever you think you have to do, half-wit. But you're going to have to answer to your brother. Your big brother. Your mean brother, Kevin Sullivan. Hogan, goodbye.
Hogan's forever. Career, Flair's career on the line. Here's a final word from the Hulkster for the Mean Gene. He's an American man.
Ladies and gentlemen, WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, Hulk Hogan! In 24 hours coming up tomorrow night in Detroit, your career is on the line. Ric Flair's career is on the line. Your title defense is going to take place inside a steel cage. Some things we've got to address here at the 11th hour. Two masked men, a question about Mr. T as a special guest referee, and first and foremost, what about this knee?
Well, you know something, Mean Gene? The word helter skelter has a whole new meaning now that I've been hanging around the WCW, brother. You know, first and foremost, Hulkamaniacs, when I'm looking at you square in the eye, I don't care about the knee, brother, because all the way to Detroit City, brother, I might run there if I have to, just to prove that I can beat Ric Flair inside a steel cage and with thousands of Hulkamaniacs in Detroit, in Joe's Arena, with Muhammad Ali with me on a ringside. I'm gonna tear Ric Flair, brother, limb from limb, dude. I'm gonna tear him limb from limb. But you know something? I'm looking at you, Mr. T. I'm looking at you right in the eye, brother. And I cornered you. And I'm gonna say it one last time, brother. I don't believe in the eye of the camera. I don't believe what I see on the videotape, brother, because I consider you a friend of mine, dude. But if you don't call it right down the middle in the steel cage, brother, I'm gonna slap you around just like you were Ric Flair's little sister, dude.
You know, on the subject of that steel cage, that means, in essence, tomorrow night on pay-per-view in Detroit, there's not going to be any outside interference. Hopefully, there won't be any outside interference.
Well, in an 18-foot-high steel cage, Mean Gene, the greatest wrestler in the world is going to have to go the extra mile to walk out of there, brother. And it's not just winning the match for me. It's the career on the line. It's all those little teeny Hulkamaniacs that have been training, saying the prayers, eating the vitamins, and believing in themselves that have me running the Hulkamania machine. And I can't let them down, brother. But in the confines of a steel cage, dude, those two so-called masked men that were out here a couple weeks ago aren't gonna have a chance to get in the cage because I'm putting Big Brother Brutai in the back. He's gonna be watching all the exits, brother. And when I get Ric Flair right where I want him, there won't be no outside interference, Ric Flair. And as I grind, and as I rip, and as I tear, you limb from limb, brother, you're gonna realize, dude, that this is where the power lies, brother. And as you drop to my knees tomorrow night, you say, Hulk Hogan, yes, you are the greatest WCW champion ever. And as you drop to your knees and say, Hulk Hogan, please don't completely destroy me. There will be no corner, brother. I will not step back an inch, brother, because inside the steel cage, I get to put the period on the legacy of Hulkamania. And after I walk out of that cage as a WCW champion, Hulkamania will be immortal and it will live forever. So what you gonna do, Ric Flair, when me and all my Hulkamaniacs destroy you?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, after tomorrow night, there will be no tomorrows for one of two men, Hulk Hogan or Ric Flair. It has been a great one. We'll see you live tomorrow night at 6:05 on TBS, 7 o'clock on TV.
What you gonna do, brother? This is the eye of the Hulkster, Ric Flair. What you gonna do in 24 hours when I destroy you?